In this video, I'm gonna continue covering very interesting tracking techniques inside DaVinci Resolve that many of you probably don't know. So let's get started with this shot from raw film. We have driver driving in the car, and if I'm gonna play it back, we can see that footage is very nice and smooth, but a little bit slightly wobbly, very little bit. And the technique I'm gonna show you works on the shots like that. Unless you shoot on a higher frame rate, you can get away with more. So the first thing I'm gonna do is give it a little quick look, so we have nice kind of cool cinematic Rec 709 going on. So let's do red-white gamut. Let's do log 3G10. And I'm gonna use my new LUT for red camera is Origami LUT. Okay, it's pretty cool new cinematic LUT. So really quick, we're gonna give it nice look. Okay, like that looks cool. Maybe a little bit kind of like that. Okay, perfect. So here we have a driver speeding, and what I'm gonna do now, very simple. I'm gonna go into the tracking, and I'm gonna go somewhere in the middle where we have potentially a good tracking point, something like this over here. I'm gonna go to stabilizer. I'm gonna click classic stabilizer. Okay, point tracker. I'm gonna click this little mouse over here, and we have a new point. I'm gonna place it here, and this time I'm gonna leave all the parameters untouched. So first I'm gonna track backwards. Okay, tracking pretty good. And then from the middle I'm gonna track forward. You don't always have to track from the middle, but it depends of how much details you have for whatever you're tracking. Sometimes it's nice to track from here. If I would start tracking from this point, for example, we wouldn't get a decent track. Okay. I think that's going to work pretty well. So, what we're going to do, click stabilize. And what we have now is a very nice, smooth shot of the car that our footage completely not moving around. It almost feels like everything is floating. So now we actually have a feeling that it was shot with like Russian arm or any kind of higher end camera tracking for the car. So we can see that it's pretty nicely locked. Now, obviously, when you do this kind of stuff, you're gonna have your shot zoomed in a little bit. So make sure initially to shoot a little bit wider. That way you have more room when you're planning on doing this kind of stuff. So from this point, we can do essentially whatever we want. If we want to change the color of the car, we can just use qualifier, for example, and continue color grading as we normally would with the normal proper technique. So let's see something like that. And then hue, we can basically do something like this. Click play, and here we have it. So this is it. It's very quick, very short, but some of you may not know this kind of technique. Just wanted to share with you guys. If you like this video, leave a comment below, click like, make sure to subscribe, and I will see you in the following videos. Take care.